Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Fire Tear of the Dragon. Chapter 1. Awakening in the Dragon's Realm. In a realm where time and reality intertwined like the roots of ancient trees, a young and restless warrior, named Odrien, awoke. The ground beneath him was soft, covered with a blanket of emerald moss, and above, the sky shimmered with a kaleidoscope of colors, painted by the wings of dragons soaring majestically. This was a world unknown to him, a world where dragons reigned supreme, not as mere beasts of lore, but as guardians of Earth. Their roars echoed like thunder, their eyes sparkled like stars, and their presence commanded both reverence and fear. Odrien, disoriented yet filled with a sense of purpose, stood up, taking in the breathtaking vista before him. As he ventured forth, the verdant forest around him seemed to whisper secrets of an ancient time. The trees stood tall and wise, their leaves rustling with the tales of yore. Birds of vibrant hues serenaded him, and the air itself thrummed with magic, a symphony of nature and enchantment. Odrien soon came upon a village, nestled in the heart of the forest, its inhabitants a mix of humans and mystical beings, living in harmony under the watchful eyes of the dragons. Here, he was greeted with curiosity and caution. The villagers, adorned in colorful garments, shared tales of their protectors, the dragons, and the balance they maintained in this world. It was in this village that Odrien first heard of the impending doom, a darkness creeping over the land, threatening to engulf everything in its shadow. The elders spoke of an ancient prophecy, one that foretold the coming of a stranger who would seek the fire tear of the greatest dragon to save their world. The fire tear, they said, was no ordinary gem. It was a tear shed by the mightiest of all dragons, imbued with the essence of life and the fierce power of fire. It was said to possess the ability to dispel any darkness, to heal any wound, and to restore balance where there was none. But obtaining it was a feat no one had ever achieved. Determined to save this world and unravel the mystery of his own presence in it, Odrien vowed to seek the fire tear. His resolve did not go unnoticed by the village seer, an old, wise woman with eyes as deep as the night sky. She beckoned him to her hut, a place filled with the aroma of herbs and the whisper of ancient spirits. Within the dimly lit hut, the seer gazed into a crystal orb, her voice a soft echo as she unveiled the path Odrien must take. His journey would lead him through the forest of whispers, across the desert of shadows, over the mountains of echoes, and finally to the dragon's keep, the lair of the greatest dragon. As Odrien set out on his quest, the village bestowed upon him gifts, a sword forged in dragon fire, a cloak woven from the silken threads of mystical spiders, and a pouch of provisions enchanted to never empty. With these, he ventured into the unknown, his heart a mix of fear and excitement. The forest of whispers was his first trial. The trees seemed to move, their shadows dancing like specters. Odrien navigated through the maze of foliage, guided by the soft whispers of the trees that told of paths untrodden and dangers lurking. He encountered creatures of legend, nymphs with eyes like the moon, and sprites that flickered like fireflies. As night fell, the forest transformed. Odrien found himself surrounded by glowing eyes, and the air was filled with the growls of unseen beasts. Relying on his wits and the sword at his side, he defended himself against the creatures that emerged from the darkness. Each battle was a test of his strength and resolve, and with each victory, his legend grew. One night, under the canopy of stars, Odrien encountered a mystical being, a guardian of the forest. This guardian, an ethereal creature with antlers that reached towards the heavens and eyes that held the wisdom of the ages, spoke of Odrien's destiny. It told him of the balance between the natural world and the realm of dragons, and how this balance was the key to finding the fire tier. With new understanding and a renewed sense of purpose, Odrien continued his journey, leaving the forest of whispers behind. Ahead lay the desert of shadows, a land of sand and mirages, where the sun blazed like a fiery eye in the sky. Odrien's path was fraught with challenges, each step a dance with danger and a leap of faith. As he journeyed, Odrien learned to listen to the whispers of the wind and to read the secrets hidden in the sands. He encountered nomads, mystics who roamed the desert, their lives a testament to the harshness and beauty of their world. From them, he learned the ways of survival, the art of finding water where none seemed to exist, and the skill of navigating by the stars. Each encounter, each challenge, brought Odrien closer to his destiny. The world of dragons, with its mysteries and wonders, had become his crucible, shaping him into Odrien he was meant to be. And as he moved ever closer to the dragon's keep, the heart of the realm, his legend grew, whispered on the winds and sung by the birds, a tale of a hero who walked with dragons, seeking the fire tear to save their world. Chapter 2. The Trail of Mysteries. The desert of shadows, a vast expanse of golden sands and mirages, lay behind Odrien as he ventured forth into new and uncharted territories. His quest for the fire tear of the dragon had led him to the edge of the mystic seas, a place where the waters whispered of ancient magic and hidden depths. Odrien's journey through the mystic seas was fraught with peril. The sea was a living entity, its moods as changeable as the winds. He navigated through storms that appeared from nowhere, their thunderous roars echoing the dragon's own, and waves that rose like towering walls, threatening to engulf him. Yet, within this chaos, he found moments of serene beauty, where the sea was a mirror reflecting the endless sky, and creatures of legend swam alongside his boat, guiding him through the treacherous waters. As he sailed, Odrien encountered islands, each a world unto itself with mysteries to unravel. On one island, hidden amidst a labyrinth of evergreen, he discovered a village where the inhabitants spoke a language of music rather than words. Their melodies conveyed emotions and thoughts, a symphony of communication that Odrien learned to interpret. Here, he uncovered a piece of the puzzle, a legend of a dragon who wept tears of fire, a tear that could light the darkest of shadows. On another island, Shrouded in perpetual fog, Odrien found an ancient library, its shelves laden with scrolls and tomes that chronicled the history of the dragons and their bond with the world. Among these texts, he found clues about the whereabouts of the dragon's keep, the lair of the greatest dragon. The library's keeper, an old sage with eyes that sparkled with knowledge, shared tales of the dragon's wisdom and power, further fueling Odrien's determination to find the Fire Tear. Each island brought new allies and enemies. Odrien faced challenges that tested not only his physical prowess, but also his intellect and spirit. He encountered sorcerers wielding dark magic, their powers a threat to the balance of the world. In battles that were as much a clash of wits as of strength, Odrien overcame these adversaries, his every victory bringing him closer to his ultimate goal. Odrien's journey across the mystic seas taught him the art of patience and the virtue of understanding. He learned to read the stars and the language of the sea, skills that were vital in navigating the ever-changing waters. His encounters with the islanders enriched his knowledge of the world and its myriad cultures, each interaction a thread in the tapestry of his quest. Leaving the mystic seas behind, Odrien continued his journey, his path now leading him to the enchanted forest, a realm where time seemed to stand still, and every leaf and stone pulsed with magic. The forest was a maze of ancient trees, their roots deep and their branches reaching towards the heavens. Here, Odrien found allies in the woodland creatures, beings of magic who recognized the purity of his quest. In the heart of the enchanted forest, Odrien came upon a clearing where the moonlight shone brightest. Here, he encountered a mystical entity, a guardian of the forest, its form ever-changing, from a majestic stag to a wise old owl. The guardian spoke of the balance of nature and the role of the dragons in maintaining this balance. It warned Odrien of the trials ahead, for the path to the dragon's keep was guarded by challenges that would test the very essence of his being. Armed with this knowledge, Odrien ventured deeper into the forest, where shadows whispered secrets and the light played tricks on the eyes. He faced illusions that sought to lead him astray, and spectral beings that tested his resolve. Each step forward was a step into the unknown, a journey into the depths of his own courage and determination. Odrien's detective-like mind, honed by the trials he had faced, became his greatest ally. He unraveled riddles that spoke of the dragon's history and puzzles that revealed hidden paths through the forest. His journey was a dance with the mysteries of the world, each step a discovery, each discovery a step closer to the Fire Tear. As he emerged from the enchanted forest, Odrien found himself at the foot of the Mountains of Echoes, a towering range that scraped the very heavens. The mountains were a formidable barrier, their peaks shrouded in clouds and their slopes steep and treacherous. Yet, Odrien's resolve did not waver. He began his ascent, his every step a testament to the strength of his will. The Mountains of Echoes were named for the voices that echoed through their valleys, voices of the past that spoke of the dragons and their ancient wisdom. Odrien listened to these echoes, gleaning knowledge and guidance from them. The climb was arduous, the path fraught with dangers, narrow ledges, sheer cliffs, and sudden avalanches. But Odrien pressed on, his eyes fixed on the summit, where the secrets of the dragon's keep awaited. As he neared the top, Odrien encountered a dragon, a creature of immense power and majesty. The dragon, seeing Odrien's determination and the purity of his heart, offered him counsel. It spoke of the fire tear and its guardian, the greatest of the dragons. Odrien listened, his mind piecing together the clues he had gathered throughout his journey. Finally, after days of climbing, Odrien stood at the summit of the Mountains of Echoes, the world sprawling below him. Here, the air was thin, and the stars seemed close enough to touch. It was a place of tranquility and power, a place where Odrien could reflect on the journey that had brought him here. With the knowledge he had gained and the allies he had made, Odrien was ready to face the final leg of his quest. The dragon's keep awaited, its secrets hidden within its ancient walls. Odrien knew that the challenges ahead would be the greatest he had ever faced, but his spirit was unbroken, his resolve unwavering. As he descended the mountain, Odrien's thoughts were of the fire tear and the darkness it could dispel. His journey had taken him across lands of magic and mystery, through trials that tested his body, mind, and soul. He had faced the unknown and emerged stronger, a true hero in every sense of the word. Odrien's path had been a trail of mysteries, each one a step towards his destiny. And as he moved closer to the dragon's keep, the heart of the dragon's realm, his story became a legend, whispered in the winds and sung by the seas, a tale of a hero on a quest to find the fire tear and save the world. Chapter 3. The Dance of Danger. Odrien's journey led him to the threshold of the dragon's keep, a fortress nestled in the heart of a valley, shrouded in a perpetual mist that whispered ancient secrets. The keep, an imposing structure of stone and magic, stood as a testament to the power and mystery of the dragons. It was here that the greatest challenge of Odrien's quest awaited him, the confrontation with the guardian dragon, the keeper of the fire tear. As he approached the keep, Odrien could feel the weight of history in every stone and the watchful eyes of the dragon upon him. The air was charged with a palpable tension, a prelude to the trials that lay ahead. The path to the keep was lined with statues of dragons, each a guardian of the past, their eyes seeming to follow his every move. The first challenge came in the form of a riddle, posed by the very gates of the keep themselves. The gates, adorned with ancient runes and images of dragons, would only open to one who could unlock their mystery. Odrien, drawing upon his experiences and the knowledge he had gained on his journey, deciphered the riddle, and the gates creaked open, granting him passage. Inside the keep, Odrien found himself in a labyrinth of corridors and chambers, each a puzzle that tested his intellect and resolve. He encountered traps and illusions, magical barriers that required him to use both his physical prowess and his sharp mind to overcome. The walls of the keep were lined with murals depicting the history of the dragons and their relationship with the world, each painting a clue to navigating the labyrinth. As Odrien delved deeper into the keep, he faced creatures of darkness, minions of the shadow that threatened to engulf the world. These beings, twisted by dark magic, were formidable opponents, each confrontation a dance with danger. Odrien fought with the sword given to him by the villagers, its blade imbued with dragonfire, cutting through the darkness with each swing. Amidst these battles, Odrien discovered allies within the keep, beings of light who had resisted the shadow's corruption. Among them was a dragonling, a young dragon whose wisdom belied its age. The dragonling, seeing the purity of Odrien's heart, offered its assistance, guiding him through the labyrinth and aiding him in his battles. Odrien's journey through the keep was a testament to his growth and strength. He faced trials that challenged not just his physical abilities, but the very essence of his spirit. He overcame obstacles that would have broken a lesser man, his determination fueled by the knowledge that the fate of the world rested upon his shoulders. In the heart of the keep, Odrien came upon a grand chamber, its ceiling lost in the shadows, its walls lined with torches that flickered with an ethereal flame. Here, he encountered the guardian dragon, a magnificent and terrifying creature, its scales shimmering like molten gold, its eyes pools of ancient wisdom. The encounter with the guardian dragon was a momentous event, a meeting of two beings from different worlds, yet bound by a common purpose. The dragon, ancient and wise, saw in Odrien a kindred spirit, a warrior of light fighting against the encroaching darkness. Odrien, in turn, saw in the dragon not just a creature of legend, but a being of profound intelligence and power. The dialogue between Odrien and the guardian dragon was a clash of wills and intellect. The dragon posed questions that delved into Odrien's heart, challenging his beliefs and his reasons for seeking the fire tear. Odrien responded with honesty and conviction, his answers a reflection of his journey and the lessons he had learned. The guardian dragon, impressed by Odrien's spirit and resolve, revealed the location of the fire tear, but with a warning, the tear was protected by a final challenge, one that would require Odrien to confront his deepest fears and doubts. Odrien, with the dragonling by his side, ventured into the deepest part of the keep, where the fire tear was kept. The final challenge was a mirror that reflected not just his physical form, but the depths of his soul. Odrien faced the reflections of his past, his fears, and his uncertainties, each a shadow that he had to overcome. The battle within the mirror was the most intense trial Odrien had faced. It was a battle not of swords, but of wills, a confrontation with the darkest parts of himself. With each shadow he overcame, Odrien grew stronger, his resolve hardened by the knowledge that he was fighting for something greater than himself. Finally, after what seemed like an eternity, Odrien emerged victorious, his spirit purified and strengthened by the trial. The mirror shattered, revealing the fire tear, a gem that glowed with an inner flame, its light a beacon in the darkness. With the fire tear in hand, Odrien and the dragonling made their way out of the keep, their path unobstructed as the labyrinth and its traps seemed to recognize Odrien's achievement. As they emerged from the keep, Odrien looked back at the towering structure, a sense of accomplishment filling his heart. But Odrien's journey was not yet over. The darkness that threatened the world still loomed on the horizon, a shadow that needed to be dispelled. With the fire tear's power in his possession, Odrien set out for the final confrontation, ready to face the darkness and restore balance to the world. Odrien's dance with danger within the dragon's keep had been a journey of self-discovery and growth. He had faced trials that tested every aspect of his being and emerged as a true hero, one worthy of legend. His story, a tale of courage, intellect, and heart, would be told for generations to come, a testament to the power of the human spirit and the enduring bond between man and dragon. Chapter 4. The Dragon's Fire Tear. With the fire tear in his grasp, Odrien emerged from the dragon's keep, his heart alight with a newfound power and purpose. The journey back to the realm of man was a reflection of his inner transformation, a path once fraught with danger now seemed to welcome him, as if nature itself recognized Odrien he had become. Odrien's return was not a solitary one. Accompanied by the dragonling, his loyal companion from the keep, and with the whispers of the guardian dragon still echoing in his mind, he journeyed towards the heart of the darkness that threatened to consume the world. As he traveled, Odrien could see the changes wrought by the shadow. Once vibrant lands now lay barren, their life and color drained by the encroaching darkness. Villages that once brimmed with laughter and life were now silent, their inhabitants either fled or fallen to despair. Odrien's resolve hardened with each step. This was a battle not just for the realm, but for the very essence of life itself. The final confrontation took place in a land that was the epitome of the shadow's corruption. The sky was a tapestry of dark clouds, and the ground was cracked and barren, devoid of life. Here, the source of the darkness revealed itself, a being of pure malevolence, a corruption of nature that sought to unmake the world. Odrien, standing before this entity, felt the weight of his journey, the sacrifices made, and the battles fought. But within him burned the light of the fire tear, a beacon in the overwhelming darkness. The battle that ensued was epic, a clash of light and dark, each blow from Odrien met with a counter from the shadowy being. The dragonling fought alongside Odrien, its youthful exuberance tempered by the wisdom it had gained from the keep. Together, they were a formidable force, their attacks synchronized and powerful. The fire tear, held aloft by Odrien, shone brighter with each passing moment, its light a stark contrast to the surrounding darkness. The fight was long and arduous, with Odrien and the shadowy being evenly matched. But as the battle raged, Odrien's resolve never wavered. He fought not just with the strength of his arms, but with the strength of his heart, a heart that had been tested and tempered through his journey. In the climax of the battle, Odrien unleashed the full power of the fire tear. A wave of pure, fiery light emanated from the gem, engulfing both him and the shadowy being. The light was blinding, a manifestation of the life and energy that the tear contained. When the light faded, Odrien stood victorious, but not unscathed. The shadowy being had been vanquished, its darkness dissipated by the fire tear's power. The land around them, once dead and barren, began to stir, as if waking from a long slumber. Green shoots broke through the cracked ground, and the sky cleared, revealing the blue expanse that had been hidden for so long. Odrien, though weary, felt a sense of peace. He had saved the realm, but more importantly, he had restored the balance between light and dark, life and death. The dragonling, its eyes reflecting pride and admiration, nuzzled Odrien in a gesture of farewell before taking to the skies, returning to the keep to share the tale of their victory. Odrien's journey back to the village was a procession of celebration. The lands he passed through rejoiced, their inhabitants coming forth to thank him for his bravery and sacrifice. The colors of life returned, painting the world in hues of green, blue, and gold. Upon his return, Odrien was greeted as a savior. The villagers, who had once looked upon him with curiosity and caution, now saw him as a legend come to life. They celebrated his victory with feasts and songs, their joy a melody that filled the air. but Odrien knew his journey was not yet complete. With the fire tear's power now a part of him, he understood that his role as a guardian of the balance was just beginning. The world was a tapestry of light and dark, and he was now its custodian. In the days that followed, Odrien worked to rebuild the lands affected by the shadow. He traveled far and wide, using the fire tear's power to heal and restore. He became a figure of legend, a wanderer who brought life wherever he went. Odrien's tale was told for generations, a story of courage, determination, and the triumph of light over darkness. He had walked with dragons, faced trials that would have broken lesser men, and emerged victorious, a true hero in every sense of the word. As years turned to decades, and decades to centuries, Odrien's legend lived on. The fire tear, once a symbol of his quest, became a symbol of hope and balance. And though Odrien eventually passed into legend, his legacy remained a reminder of the power of the human spirit and the enduring bond between man and dragon. In the heart of the realm, where the dragon's keep stood tall and proud, the guardian dragon watched over the world, its eyes reflecting the legacy of Odrien who had once sought the fire tear. And in the skies above, dragons soared, their roars a song of life and power, a tribute to Odrien who had saved their world.